I'm Molly Thomas in the Cox's Bazar region of Bangladesh. We are in the world's largest refugee camp. What is Canada's role beyond our own borders? We speak to Canadians offering their skills and expertise to some of the most persecuted people on the planet.
Honestly, every single time I go into the camps, it's just like my mind just is blown by just the sheer size of everything.
We're here with Alyssa Horvat, a recent graduate of the Monk School of Global Affairs back in Canada, but shortly after graduation actually came over to Bangladesh to help here with the Rohingya crisis. Alyssa, what is it like? I mean, going from the classroom to frontline helping people in need like that.
I would say it's very interesting because it really brings together what you learn in class and what you read on the news every day and kind of hits you in the face with all of that all at once. For me, within my first month, I was able to actually have the opportunity to talk to beneficiaries here. And I actually had to leave the discussion with them because I just couldn't deal with the emotions because it was, I had been reading and I'd been following what was going on for the months prior to actually arriving. But when I actually got here, I think I just wasn't ready for how much it was going to hit me. But that being said, it really gave me this renewed desire to do as much as I could to help while I was here.
What is it like? I mean, part of probably that what hits you is that these people are young. A lot of them are young, mm-hmm. right? So many school-age kids, so many kids that are adolescents and don't have anything to do. Mm-hmm. Do you feel a special sense of maybe a camaraderie around that? Because you also are young.
I mean, I find a lot of the time when I'm in the camps and I'm around the Rohingya population, I always tend to just smile at them and kind of just try and convey with my eyes what I can't necessarily say with my words, that, you know, I'm here for you, I understand you, and that kind of thing. And it's upsetting to see a lot of young people that are here in this situation where they can't necessarily have the opportunities that I had, but then I also know that everyone's involvement here, my organization's involvement, and just the whole response is trying to, you know, build that up and trying to find some way to mitigate that problem.
Do people know you're Canadian? I always wonder. I see the Canada flag up on many different places around. Mm-hmm. Do they know? Do they care?
I would say that if they do know, that they do care and they do appreciate it. For example, when we go on donor visits when Bob Rae has come, or we've had other higher level officials from Global Affairs Canada, sometimes the beneficiaries will have little signs that say like, thank you Canada, that sort of thing. On a day-to-day basis, I don't know if they know as much. I think they just assume we're not from here. But in the opportunity that they do get to find out we are, they tend to be grateful and happy that Canada's involved.
There's so many young Canadians out there that have no idea what's going on here mm-hmm. in Bangladesh. What would you say to them? What would be your message to, I guess, your peers?
Well, I would say that this is something that we shouldn't just forget and we shouldn't just let it slide. Canada's been really vocal throughout this crisis and just in terms of, you know, keeping it in the news and making statements about and advocating for the Rohingya people, and obviously providing financial support as well over the shorter term and the longer term. I know IOM has benefited significantly from that as well. So I would say just, you know, keep the government keeping this on its agenda, keep involved, keep kind of pushing for more to be done and that advocacy, because I think that that is really what's going to be needed in the long term.
Sarah, Canada has been very vocal on the Rohingya crisis politically. You're working frontline though on the humanitarian lines. What? Mm-hmm. How does that make you feel?
Well, Canada is one of the donors here, which playing a very big role because they are very flexible with their donation, and it makes it very, very easy for us because we can actually use the donation based on the needs on the ground and the priorities. So it's very nice to be a Canadian here because, yeah. Because you see Canadian flags everywhere, and you know that people knows about Canada here.
Do they? That's yeah. I mean, that's always my question. Do they know? Do the kids know when they talk to you?
Yeah, well, the kids, small kids probably not, but most of the people, because even if they don't ask you as the first question when they meet you, the second question definitely is about your country and which country you are coming from.
Yeah, so, we felt that too.
Yes, so Canada, when you mention Canada, they are all like, wow, Canada is a great country. Mm. Or sometimes even they have some families back in Canada, so they are quite familiar with Canada. They know Justin Trudeau, so.
He's kind of famous.
Yes, and they sometimes even talk about the climate, that it's cold in compared with here, and how I deal here with this heat.
Sarah, what is Canada's role, do you think, in this crisis? Because now we're past the year point, mm-hmm. and we, you know, kind of have to figure out which way we're going to move.
Yeah, I think Canada had a, I don't know, big role so far in terms of women and girls' rights and their protection. It's very important to keep doing it because 80% of the people here in the camp is kids and women. Most of them, they are coming from small communities, and they are not used to this, you know, big, huge area, so many people. They used to live together for years and years. They knew all the secrets about each other. So now here with so many unfamiliar faces, it's, you know, such a simple thing. Just the padlock can give us so much security and safety.
Is this job emotional for you?
Sometimes yes, because I don't know, it's, you see all these people. I'm spending lots of time here in the camps with their kids, babies, women, and when I see like all these pregnant women trying to, I don't know, climb all these hilly areas, you know, during monsoon when everywhere is muddy and it's not easy even for me with all these proper shoes, you know, it's difficult. So yeah, sometimes it is emotional. You get emotional, and at the end of the day, you know, you think, okay, I'm doing something. Yeah.
Thanks for what you do.